Previously, I replaced carbon fiber frames with 3D printed frames, but this time every part on this bed has been replicated and 3D printed. So here it is, guys, the Goose Guy S2 that's mostly 3D printed. We have the front chassis bracket, the flight controller tray that the flight controller is sitting on, the battery tray, the landing skids, the motor mount that sits here on the bottom, both the frame adapters on either side, anti-rotation bracket, tail boom block, tail boom, as well as the vertical stabilizer that also holds the tail motor. Now, it was quite substantially hard to make this happen, but I made it work. All the screws that you had to install, I made sure that you were using the original hardware. I know that majority of these screws are machine screws, so the hole tolerances were much smaller to make sure that they're seated properly. Eventually, I'll be using self-tapping screws, but as far as printing goes, I had to print majority of these parts at 0.1 millimeters just due to the fact that they are so small, making sure that accuracy is at its highest priority. Some of the printing of these parts had to be modified, one of which were the landing skids to increase the strength. I had to print them flat just like this so the pattern goes left to right while it's sitting on the bed of the 3D printer, and then eventually you can use a lighter to heat up the corners and then bend them into shape. Originally, I was using a hairdryer, or if you have a heat gun, I was heating up the entire landing skid and it ended up not working out because when you're trying to hold one part of the landing skid, it ended up deforming the entire thing when you're trying to form them into its proper shapes. Then the tail boom block. The tail boom block looks like a nice chassis, a square cube chassis like this, but printing that would not be possible because it wouldn't be as strong. So I had to make a solid tail boom block that the tail boom would be able to go into. And then I had the slot here on the bottom to compress the tail boom to sit in its place. And of course you have the set screw here up top. Now, the vertical stabilizer, there are two pieces in the vertical stabilizer, but I merged them into one so that I wouldn't have to worry about multiple pieces. And now as far as the tail boom goes, there is a bar that sits there so that the screws have something to screw into to hold the vertical stabilizer in the tail boom. But instead what I ended up doing is I printed a bar inside the tail boom itself so that could also reduce part count. So that is mostly it for this 3D printed Goose Guy S2. Let's go take it outside and see how it test flies. Guys, that flew extraordinarily well. I am impressed with how well this was able to hold up compared to the original parts that were on this helicopter. And if you guys are curious on how I reverse engineered this, or if you have any sort of questions, please comment down below. And if I have enough people that are very interested in these files, I might consider posting them online. So please like and subscribe, and I'll definitely do a lot more flying videos. Those were just the test flights, and thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one.